Congratulations, guys, first off and foremost. Now, I got to talk about the moment where you guys were just going to needed 1 point left to win. What was that like?
I was really nervous. I think doing what we were playing, because first game we got second place, second game we won, so yeah, we're going to try and do the same thing and hopefully win again.
And hopefully have more than a 1 point buffer, right?
Yeah, definitely.
For sure. Now just coming over here to you, what has it been like to be here at the Fortnite World Creative Cup, just playing in front of this audience, you know, hearing everybody cheer for you guys to win? What is that like?
It's fun. That's the only thing I can think of. It's fun. You compete against everyone else, meet your teammates, and just have fun.
Yeah, and have you guys had a chance to play together before? Is this your first time playing together as a team?
I don't hear it, sorry.
Is it your first time playing together as a team?
Yeah, it's the first time.
Well, you guys definitely make it look super easy. Thank you all so much for being here and talking to me. I'm going to let you get back, get your synergy back together. Sundown and Monster, back to you up at the desk.
Thank you so much, Pookie and the Funky Fresh Fighters. I mean, their game plan has themselves. Second place, first place. Now, I understand why you might want to bandwagon a little bit, but I'm still going to hang out with them around the world. But I want to talk about the changes we saw from match one to match two in terms of gameplay. And was it what you expected?
Definitely not what I expected. I thought Gotaga's team was going to come out here and crush it right behind FishBam. But as you can see, you just said kind of go through which way. Talk about, like, kind of beginner's luck or something. Just put a team together. They didn't practice. They just come out of here and wiping players up. So a lot of talented players here.
I mean, Tawaya talked about it. He was like, hey, when I pick my team, very confident there with their death run ability. Want to see what they do in the elimination race during World Run. But really well so far at Sky Station. That's going to be a confidence booster, because if you can get the Silver Llama there,
yeah, you're just one step closer. So with the first place and the second place, they're clearly having a good set so far here at the Sky Station show.
Yeah, it's been very well done for them, but it's still anybody's game. Don't forget, the winner of the silver is the one who has accumulated the most prize money across, which equates roughly to placements, but you don't get punished if you're placing in that bottom half, 4th through 8th, while receiving the same amount of prize money in each one of the matches.
Yes, everyone is a winner, so you really have to fight till the end, regardless if you're in the lead or not. These guys are prize.
We've seen the difference in 10 seconds in that circle. 120 right there, it makes a huge difference, but enough of us breaking down. We're going to throw it outside to Bala, because he's going to show us what's up with the tactics. Bala, what do you got for us?
I'm out here at the Fan Festival, and I don't have a bandwagon here, but maybe after this set I'll have to hop on somewhere with Monster. We got a ton of awesome action. I've been watching it, and I have to show you guys what went down in that first and second game. First off, the Llama Record Company with an amazing take. He was on the point. Every single time they went up to the point, two angles, and the sword approach at the sensor, what made sure that he was the most important person not to go down. You see there, Hand of Blood and his teammate all backing up. He's going to have an engagement on the side. These sword fights are really easy for him to just mow it down, but immediately as he realizes his teammates are up on the point, about to get up, about to push the ramp, he comes up from the side, slices the dice. But meanwhile, falling down the leaderboard. If you look right now where they're at, they're only in second place. FishBam was ahead of them. Scissors was dancing and talking all the smack, telling his teammates to try to get the crowd involved. It was Llama Record Company making the plan, making the play to get in towards the center. Absolutely amazing take on this first game. Let's a Hand of Blood stay.
this is what matters right here, is stopping the Funky Fighters, because clearly they have been doing some good work together as a team so far. Tomoya is off to the races here, though, set to run away. Can the Sunshine Soldiers come back? Can the Cuddle Crew make a big appearance for themselves? Because they can really shake it up here. If you go any which way, depending on who has the most victories, really, and the best placement.
Yeah, so currently you will see the fact that they're able to push off right there. Wanna record go putting shots down towards this one. You don't want to peek, though, because the hunting rifles will be coming out in the shot. Just misses Carnifex right there. And he trades back down. Pitching, firing it off. He gets pushed out by Raven's Revenge.
Carnifex having a tough time kind of listening in there. Carnifex was sniped from the side. Now we have Taldak here jumping right in from the Littlewood Warriors. He's going toe-to-toe. So Tog is down and out.
So, if I'm the Llama Record Company, and I know I've won a match, and then I did okay in the last one, they were in fourth, so they were there, they're close. Funky Fighters have a win in the second place. Do you send somebody to just hard deny the Funky Fighters the entire time? You don't get the Silver Llama if you don't, right? If the Funky Fighters finish above you, they're going to be finished off. Do you think they can spare somebody to do that, though? But it's better off to deny them than it is to push up the top.
Yeah, but the problem is, Ben, the Little Wars have been so consistent, you literally allow them to snipe the competition because you over-focus. So I think the play here is play your game, and if anything, stay away. Let the rest of the server do that, you know, gritty work for you, and dominate the other side. Take that victory.
There you go. I like to hear it, Monster. That's fantastic analysis. That's why we keep you around. The breakdown and making sure you challenge the initial opinion there as the Raven's Revenge are able to get on the top and in a fantastic spot of control right now, building up.
Yeah, even, like, the Taga's team is still in this. They've been doing, like, relatively well so far. Here it is. He just kind of goes toe-to-toe, and Ninja strikes him right down. Oh, but... Hey. His teammate comes on in, Raven's Revenge. Who is that? Magma comes right up to the top. And give you guys a little fun fact about Magma. He's from Australia. He started playing in Fortnite Season 2. His favorite aspect of creative mode is actually speedrunning. Always finds new ways to kind of play the game.
I mean, good on him, man. I get incredibly frustrated by that, but then watching these guys do the speedruns and how quickly they go through and how efficiently, it just reminds me why we're up here talking about it and watching them do this creative madness as Scissors cuts through the competition, goes straight up to delay and right back down. Cuddle Crew not quite able to get him. He goes up again, so right now just denying the Cuddle Crew the points. But we talked about how we wanted to see more of them right now pushing into the top three.
Yes, the Cuddle Crew, come on, make a big appearance. Every game is worth so much. You, at the very least, want to be up in that top four contestant so that you can take a little bit more home with you. Here it is, Ninja. Disengages, actually just takes down Magma. And hey, I like the strat here. He says, you know what, I got low health, let's just get back on this respawn wagon. Doesn't even give anyone the satisfaction of stealing the siphon.
That's about to say, no siphon, no materials, quick reset, knows he can get out there, was basically in his spawn anyway. That is the type of competitive edge Ninja always looks to give himself.
That was like 200 IQ, low key right there. That was very well played. But back to Gotaga. And Hand of Blood here in the same shot. Hand of Blood just, he can't do much. He knows there's a team up there. Waits for his entire squad to go up the ramp and then hops right to the top. But now back to Gotaga, who's on this point by himself. He wants to kind of bait him into the close. Can he get the hit? And he does. Goes right down, straight to the top.
That was sick, using the jump right as the animation had started to make sure he took him from the bottom, dodged the Funky Fresh Fighter out. Gotaga now getting pinched from the side. Three of the Funky Fresh Fighters up there doing everything. Will come out, trying to find Gracious back up to try and get some defense there. For Gotaga, just going to disengage.
It's actually prime movement right there as well. You just see him baiting and switching, going back and forth, trying to get in there, see if he can kind of sneak in and get some extra damage. And here it is, someone's in front of him. He only needs 2 swipes. He goes down and gets the siphon. Oh, cannot convert another, which would have kept him in the game. His teammates are here, though.
We're seeing a lot more points being sorted. A little more top-heavy this game, going towards the 10-minute mark right now, with Raven's Revenge and Llama Record Co. 100 points clear of the rest of the field.
Unfortunately, though, the Funky Fighters have fell to the bottom of the totem pole. If they can't come up to the top, they actually are pushing themselves way out of the average running for the win of this set, so they really need a massive comeback here. But Savannah is showing why he's here with 13 eliminations already, and bye-bye. Ball's down. Lucky for him. No
one of his... Yeah, that's what he said. And that might be one of those moments where you opt for deny, and in fact, he does say, hey, I'm at 5 HP anyway. I'll see you in a bit. I gotta respawn.
Smart. Playing Sunshine Soldiers having a spot to themselves as well right now. Not quite sure who they pushed out here, but the Impulse are flying overhead. And so Taga, they're doing so good at holding the point here. And this is why they're in the number one lead. But they don't have too much cushion to play with.
No, particularly when 12 points per second on that central point lead is open. So Taga checking his surroundings. No shots coming through. RCA using the door edit, just a little counter edit to make sure that nobody is able to come up and contest him. And then just starts raining shots down towards the defense. Making their lives difficult this game, but up comes Ninja. Our damage goes down. Chappy goes down. Taga really be able to find the last hit. Ninja intelligently backs away and strafes it out. Teammate picks that one up, and they get